Hi guys and girls, a very simple lesson with modes. Modes are something that a lot of people don't seem to understand. Really quickly, if you look at all the white keys on the piano, that's the key of C, no sharps or flats. It doesn't matter what note you choose to make your home base, start point, tonal center, whatever you want to call it, it's the key of C. So if I wanted to play A to A, white keys only, I would be in the key of C, but I'd be playing A minor. If I wanted to play E to E in the key of C, I would be a type of E minor. Now what I've done is I've just recorded a little G power chord. So there's only two notes, G and D. There's two G's here, just for a little riff. Now what that does is the simpler the chord or the less notes in a chord, it gives you more options with your modes. I'm just gonna play six of the seven modes over that same repeated progression. So like just Ionian. Dorian. Phrygian. Lydian. Mixolydian. Aeolian. Now Joe Satriani talks about using different modes over the same chord in a thing called a pitch axis theory, something like that. He'll be doing like that kind of idea, as is waffle, but that's like using a Dorian, then going to Ionian, then Lydian. That kind of idea is very typical of him. So what's happening there is, for those who don't have any idea what modes are, I can't explain it in 5 minutes. It's other than the white keys principle. But what's happening here is G. G and D. Now, when you look at all of your modes, six of the seven modes have the same first and fifth note in terms of like the semitone degrees between them. So if I was to use six of my seven modes over a G and a D, that means all the other notes in those scales or modes change except for the first and the fifth. That's why, so Ionian, the one and the five are the same. Now for Dorian, one and five are the same. And for Phrygian, one and five are the same. One and five are the same. Now for Mixolydian, one and five are the same. And Aeolian, one and five, the same. So what you can see there is, because the chord that I'm playing is actually only one and five technically, that means in a seven note scale, two of the notes always stay the same. That gives me five other notes to play with. So I can create incredible melodies. I'll just improvise. Now I'm mixing a few together there. Govan suggests that you don't mix them too much because you lose definition or you lose the flavour of the individual mode. So what I did that time around, just before, was I did mix them around a little bit too much, so you're not really sure where I am. But if I make more statements and phrases, you'll hear how you can really choose your melodies. So I'll be a bit simpler this time. Now if I want to make Ionian to Lydian, you can really hear that Satriani or Led Zeppelin-y kind of feel. And if I want to make things bluesy, I can go... Now if I wanted to take major to minor, because the chords aren't affecting those other notes in the modes, I've got the freedom to choose the melody I want. That's why a lot of rock bands and a lot of rock guitarists like to solo over power chords, and often one power chord, because you've got so much melodic choice. If your rhythm is complex chords, quite often you're boxed into only one scale, unless you want to do altered things which involve dissonance and atonal, you know. But this is all about really being creative over the top of something simple. That's really nice and Ionian. Let's go bluesy.